Okay, there we go. Now we're live. I don't know what that was going on, but hopefully this time we're actually going to stay live. Yeah. How's it going, everyone? I'm not sure if the other stream went through or not, but hopefully it did. I think it did. So, yeah. Just to quickly recap. I had issues streaming last month because my internet was being throttled, so we're gonna try to pick up the one game I was trying to stream before I realized, oh shit, my internet was being throttled. Wait, hold on. Because you guys might want to see the intro. Give it a moment. There we go. So, this is a game about dimensions, and it came out a little bit after Portal 2, I believe. Someone could fact check that really quickly and let me know, then I could correct myself, but I think it came out a little bit after Portal 2. But it's a really fun game. May or may not do the DLC, so we're just gonna do a new game for the third time. Hopefully, no problems.
Once upon a time, that's how these things usually start, yes? A sister took pity on her brilliant, prolific, and incredible brother. She had somehow gotten it in her head that he might be lonely, or at least that's what she claims. And so, on a perfectly fine, productive Friday afternoon, the sister picked up her son from the Elwood Academy for Boys and dropped the aggravating child off on the brother's doorstep. Now you, I mean, the boy, had visited Quadrangle Manor on a few occasions. Each time was complete with a grand entrance from the brother, who was in fact a professor and inventor with a profound and soaring intellect. With each visit, the inventions he exhibited became more slick and cutting edge. The boy eagerly awaited the revealing of the professor's latest contrivance, but this, the most captivating of visits, started a bit differently. Well, let's see here. If I configure the transdimensional velocity regulator at approximately 0.887 microseconds past the... Oh, you're here? I have the most incredible invention to show you this visit. Unfortunately, I'm a bit indisposed at the moment.
Hey, Gramps.
If you take your luggage into the foyer, I will join you as soon as I can.
Okay, Gramps.
Oh, you confounded machine. Oh. What was that? Oh, good. That should be a safety release for the door up there somewhere. Where on earth did I put that?
I thought I could just kind of like rocket myself up in the air with this.
Oh yes, I'd forgotten. You're not particularly tall, are you? You should be able to use your luggage to give you an extra boost.
Yeah, eventually if you can't solve the puzzles, he'll give you a straight up hint. Whoops.
Wait a minute. Something isn't quite right here. Oh no, 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 no! Ah!
right now. The security uplink on my watch still seems to work, so I can see you and... Hello? You can hear me, right? Jump around a bit if you can. Ah! It seems as if I can still tap into the intercom system. Well, I most certainly can do better than this. Testing, 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 testing!
There. Ha! Much better. Now, what in the world are you doing here? Were you supposed to be here today? No matter. Well, judging from the current underwhelming amount of light in this room, we're still on backup power. My head is killing me. It seems as though I now possess a rather large epidural hematoma. A bump on the head. Do me and yourself a favor and head to the front hall. There's a way to restart the power grid. Last I remember, I was in the new technology sector, and then... I don't know.
A little bit of slowdown. Yeah, the frames might drop.
If you head over to my office over on the left, you should be able to restart the manor's power grid. Throw that switch there. It should be the one. Well, that wasn't as effective as I'd hoped. You'll have to reactivate the generators in each sector in order to lift the current lockdown. Just, take the glove in the box with you. I wish you could see my facial expression right now, as I am not pleased. What you are holding is an early prototype of the interdimensional ship device, or IDS device for short. It's one piece of my latest invention that should come in handy. Get it? You know, because it's a glove. If you can access the generator at the back of each wing, we might be able to lift the lockdown on the rest of the house. It seems as if the breaker did unlock the blue wing. Well, I suppose you should start there first.
If you're wondering why I'm not saying much, it's because this guy likes to talk a lot. And I don't want to interrupt whatever he's saying. But, power glove, I gotta made the joke twice.
There's something I must tell you. My latest invention has required me to make a few adjustments to the house since the last time you barged in. Visited.
Now we're getting to the puzzles. Right now it's just easy stuff.
Now, one of the topics that our family has been studying for several generations are rifts, existing between various dimensions. I've been able to develop a power source that will channel enough energy into one of these dimensional rifts that it can be widened enough to travel through. The glove controls the power source, which allows you to travel to whichever dimension has rifts in the area. You won't have control over the ability to switch dimensions yet. Just be patient. This door is using one of my inventions, the repetitive, periodic, articulating gruidae, or a drinking bird, except it's far more advanced. Well, because your glove is an early prototype, it has a few limitations in terms of dimension accessibility and the distance it can be from a receptacle in order to function. This is such an early experiment with dimensional shifting, so I decided to have it triggered remotely with the drinking bird. Instead of operating a door, the bird will trigger a dimensional shift. There's an IDS battery in the machine that will power the dimensions, which in this case is Fluffy Dimension.
In addition to Fluffy being embarrassingly adorable, it's also rather useful because everything is 10 times lighter than normal. Though that looks like a regular scale, it is in fact a portable kinetic mass to electricity converter. There's that lovely bird again. Sometimes I call him Desmond.
What a lovely name.
Something to note. Since you're holding a version of the IDS device, you, in fact, are not the you in an alternate dimension. Let me try that again. You remain constant, so no matter the dimension, your mass, shape, speed, and trying personality remain the same.
As you can already tell, my commentary is not very interesting at the moment, because this is, the third time I had to go through the tutorial. The previous two was during the throttling of the internet, so I'm a little bit meh. Making some wise moves and whatnot.
You should throw that IDS battery into the receptacle mounted on the wall.
Check this shit out, Gramps. Huh! Damn it. Let me try that again.
That receptacle will distribute the power source around the room, allowing you to now use your IDS device to switch dimensions at your leisure.
Also, this game does drop frames really often in-game. I don't think it's that well optimized, but hey.
As I mentioned, dimensional rifts in the manor are magnified by the stabilizing energy from the IDS receptacle and batteries. This is what enables you to slip between dimensions when you're wearing the IDS glove. Ah, that's Dolly. Dynamic Object Linear Ligation Interface. To you, a cloning device. I like my house just so. So I decided to add functionality to her to keep everything consistent. I'll need to tune that later.
Gotta get the battery. So this is just to get used to the mechanics of the game.
These are my own particular hybrid beams of carbon dioxide and neodymium doped yttrium aluminum garnet lasers using an alternating ray configuration. Gives them an extra kick.
Down here? Nope. And yes, those lasers will kill me. Gramps just does not give a shit.
Unfortunately, the breaking of this glass is a necessary evil. Don't take that as permission to do it elsewhere. Just letting you know that you reset the glass. Thank you.
This one took me a while. Well, not really, but still. What you need to do is take this and just go around. Puzzles do get actually a lot harder later on. And they seem to be mostly based off of reaction timing, I think. It's been a long time. I only played this game when it first launched. I haven't played much of the DLCs because they were really hard.
Oh, that creature there is an interdimensional kinetic entity, or Ike.
Ike is kind of creepy looking, to be honest. Okay. Nope, that's not what I want you to do. Come on.
Stop for a minute and take a look at the painting. The machine I referred to as Dolly started out as a simple metal forge that had been in the family since medieval times. The original quadrangle suit of armor was actually constructed in this very forge.
Neat.
My great-grandfather modified the old forge so that if it had enough raw resources, it could craft steel objects autonomously. This predecessor to Dolly supplied all the materials needed to build the Underground Railroad. This machine single-handedly won the Civil War. Not really. I made my own modifications to my great-grandfather's designs. The current Dolly specifications do not require any raw materials. For example, Dolly converts energy from the radioactive science juice directly into matter. I never did sort out why she makes so many copies of things. Oh well, you can never have too many safes, or chairs, or coffee tables.
Okay, but answer me this, Gramps. Why does it have a tongue? Does it really need a tongue?
In case you're wondering, you turned on the fan. Please say that you don't need to explain that to me. Standard issue conveyor belts. Sometimes laziness should be indulged.
There's a blueprint here. Let me check. He's not exactly a looker. And if you get too close, obviously he disappears. It's kind of dumb.
That's where that got to. That is a botched experiment of mine called the Awkward Noise Generator. There's got to be more around here somewhere.
What a very relatable object.
I haven't discussed my location a whole lot, but it seems as if I'm in some sort of limbo. I think I may explore a bit and see what turns up.
Let me check something really quickly. Just to make sure. Okay, no drop frames, nothing too weird. Good. I hate doing that, having to check, and then it pauses the game. But it seems like it only drops frames when you're entering a new puzzle room, or whatever you want to call it. Test chamber? Puzzle room? It's got to solve no matter what.
Why? Well, at least avoid impaling yourself horribly. It's bad enough the glass needs to be tidied up.
Gramps does not want me having fun. Don't throw the safe. There you go. Oh, this is kind of neat. And then you can make your own pathway with the fan. Apparently you're strong enough to hold these things while the fan is blowing.
This room often gets rather sweltering in the summertime. Air circulation is very important.
I am not sure when, blueprints are another collectible you can get in this game.
Physicality that still completely baffles me.
Am I really quiet? How's this? Actually, better yet, let me just adjust everything a little bit. How's that? Actually, let me. I'm not sure why my headset is being so quiet, but okay. Thank you for letting me know, though. I mean, compared to, like, video game... Oh, no. Quiet and muffled. You have died. Thing... Number 212, you'll never experience. Judging others for their choice of transportation. I don't know why it's like that. That's really weird. Hold on. What if I turn up this? Is this better? I know that in my yesterday's stream, I was very, very quiet, and I took note of that. Barely? It's gotta be something with the... Well, moving on. Tell us your life story, Gramps.
This is one of the animals that Dolly cloned to rather, well, intriguing results. Thus was produced the world's first and only fully elastic dog. I named her Angstrom. You know, come to think of it, it reminds me of this toy from the 80s. Stretch something.
Is still very weird that my microphone's still quiet. What if I just boost it up to like 80% like that? Is that better? Hopefully.
Ah, you've moved on to a part of the manor where another type of dimensional rift is accessible. This is the Gravid Wolfram dimension, or Heavy for short. This dimension is in direct opposition to the Fluffy dimension and will make things 10 times heavier.
So the heavy metal dimension. Hey, Ike. He's even got a little name tag. Look at that. Hi.
He's a bit on the shy side. Give him some time to get used to it.
There's not really a change. That is odd. That is very odd. Whoops. Alright, I'll have to troubleshoot that some other time, but if you can actually hear my voice now, then that's at least good, right? I know I tend to keep the volume down for the game to like for like Stardew Valley, which by the way I'm gonna pick that back up Thursday. What am I doing? I need to solve this. Oh yeah. Good. Because the microphone is really up close to my mouth right now. I'm not sure what's going on, unless it's something wrong with the headset itself. I've actually had that issue with Discord as well. Like, I've been told that my microphone's too quiet on Discord. I don't have any, like, special settings going on with my headset either. Just kind of plug it in and just, you know, use it. One of these has to change. This one? Nope, that's not what I wanted. This one's a little bit more trial and error.
Now just imagine how long it took me to lay all that out. Be careful. I'd help you, but I've honestly forgotten which Dolly is hooked up to which power converter.
Might be this. Yeah, there we go. not hit that switch bird. There we go. Now you may hit the switch.
Some dimensions are tightly bound together, like the one we're in right now, and also the fluffy and heavy dimensions.
So what do you think of the game so far, chat? It's pretty neat, isn't it?
That red battery will provide enough energy to enable the IDS device to widen the heavy dimension rifts in this area. It appears this dolly got stuck on an infinite loop. How unfortunate. There seems to be a large expanse of piles and pits filled with various random objects. No, not where you are. Here, in this confounded place. Are those hard candies? They're a little fuzzy. Ugh. Nice job. With the increased density and higher melting points of items in heavy dimension, quadrangle laser beams are rendered rather ineffectual. Most things in life, timing is key. I came across Ike some time ago, and he decided to follow me back to the manor. I believe Ike stole these and hid them at one point. He's rather fond of shiny objects.
Careful. That's much better.
Not half bad. This was once the family cat, Lord Widget Pompadour Fluffington IV, or Widget I. He somehow wound up in one of the Dolly cloning control units. I specifically constructed his monocle to fit him. Who knew it would be so impossible to find a cat-sized monocle? Preposterous. Sadly, Widget I has since passed on.
But his memory is alive. Somewhat. So I want to clarify that Dolly is great for cloning inanimate objects, but she's not entirely capable with organic ones. This is Widget's first generation clone. We named this one Colonel Fluffy McScratchers, or Widget the Second. Widget the Second is still mostly together and functional as a cat, but just a little wall-eyed.
A little bit?
I just had to pass Widget the Second through Dolly again. I just couldn't resist. Definitely learned my lesson with this one. Technically, his name is Widget the Third, though he often responds to derp. I often find him walking around in circles while staring at his feet. Very friendly, but possesses the intelligence of a sack of rocks.
Fun.
Note that if you disrupt the blue beam, it should deactivate something.
This, huh? Right, these guys, these are not so heavy. Thank you.
I'm not entirely sure how many BEDs of radiation that emits. Hope you're not looking to have children later. Apparently this unit needs a little bit of work.
Oh shit, I forgot, I put on Pillow Dimension. Whoops. I guess that's just a habit.
This place is truly fascinating. That, combined with the fact that I have no clue how I was transported here, is certainly puzzling. It's mostly dark. Well, maybe not dark. Sort of twilight.
Whoops. Oh. Crouch? No, no crouch. This all over again. I don't think he's going to be in a closet somewhere in the manor. I can assure you that. That's a good educated guess. Considering how goofy this game is. I shouldn't have jumped into that. Thing number 23 you'll never experience. Accomplishing your dreams, unless your dream was dying alone in a manor, in which case, good job.
The number 3 to be a very satisfying number. It's a Heitner number, and the proper amount of scoops on an ice cream cone.
Whoops. This one might be a little bit tricky. Can't jump through it. Thing number 524 you will never experience: forgetting an anniversary.
I find the number 3 to be a very satisfying number. It's a Heitner number, and the proper amount of scoops on an ice cream cone. Could have done it better myself. Not bad, though. You may remember some of my past inventions from previous trips. This is my ice gun, Freezy Ray Vaughn.
Woohoo!
This is a compression platform which uses photoelectric energy to function. Like a spring, the energy pulses below the platform excite the molecules in the air, stimulating an elastic structural rigidity.
There's something up there. And I can't climb that. I need the safe.
Clearly, your parents have been raising you splendidly. I was wondering where Ike put that.
Oh. But where's the box? There's the box.
Now I see a giant pit filled with keys.
I think the Doom might have found Kingdom Hearts. I don't know.
Just remember, you need enough change in the mass to build up enough mechanical energy.
Why is it not going that high? Is there anything supposed to be coming out of here? I'm pretty sure I have to take this with me. I think it just needed to be centered. Now the physics is not working properly. I think the joke that they're trying to go with where his location is, I think it's supposed to be a pocket dimension. Because it's like a pit of keys and then like candy with like fuzz on it. You know, know, stuff that you would just shove in your pocket. What am I supposed to do? Because I can't get that up here. Okay. I get it. But I kind of need this.
It's time to spring into action.
Nope.
I cracked myself up.
Only I'm allowed to pun.
Satisfying, isn't it?
But I want to know where that whistling is coming from. I kind of want to get that. Is it even worth getting to?
Supposed to whistle while you work and grin and whatnot.
There we go. I probably have missed a few. There's only supposed to be like one annoying thing.
This
per
is
level.
One of my past inventions, Joan the Jetpack. Worked just fine, except I had some serious trouble with the hover-up feature. Somewhat flammable. Some might say incendiary.
I'm just checking to make sure. I'm just checking the microphone again.
You probably never saw this invention. It was my hole digger. We called it Every Day I'm Shoveling. And by we, I mean Ike. It was a little too efficient. This was the first and last time I saw it.
Yeah, you can tell this game likes to play on puns with music. Not sure if it's memeing, but could be.
One can never be too safe. Pun, pun, pun. I was quite the champion at shot put during my years in college on the track and field team.
Substitute a safe with a chair or completely botch that. Yeah, my brain's a little bit fried today, as you can tell.
The electromagnetic microreactors, or electrovets if you're so inclined, will all require a conductive polycell. I also happen to be on the basketball team as well. You may want to try the lid as a backboard. Nice shot!
To move that a little bit closer. Right. Good. Good.
Hooped it. Why?
Hey.
I believe you're close to the generator in that sector. A little further. My head feels like I've been hit squarely by a 2x4, and I still haven't regained my memory. That's splendid. So, you need to be over by that blast door, but it looks like you're going to have to go through the object distribution system to get there.
Oh, fun.
Jump! This is definitely not the right place for you to be.
Think?
Easy now.
Oh, wrong side. Whoops. Thing 39 you will never experience. Defaulting on a mortgage.
Easy now.
Good, good, good. And yes, that couch just spontaneously disappeared.
Sure.
Yeah. Or does this take me back around again? Nope, it doesn't. Ooh.
Almost there. What he's eating there.
What? Where's Ike? Whoa. I almost botched that. Almost botched it. You. Whoa. Ooh. This kid must be really athletic to be able to pull this stuff off.
Nice.
The generator room for this sector is ahead.
Hey, look at it this way. The worst that can happen is that you fail miserably. Fantastic, you made it. If you can get to the generator, I'll tell you what to do.
Oh. Ooh.
For your general health and safety, I would recommend disabling those. The switches for the laser beams should be up there.
But I'm down here. And I'm dead. Thing number 104, you will never experience. Looking back at this and laughing. How about you just restart me somewhere where I didn't botch this?
For your general health and safety, I would recommend disabling those. The switches for the laser beams should be up there. Somewhere.
Remember this part at all. Eh, fuck it. Into the pit I go. I think it might have been intentional. That was not intentional. That is the game laughing at me. You will never experience awkwardly ignoring a person holding a petition. Not gonna lie, that noise, the laser noise, is kind of drilling into my head. Damn it. Maybe I'm supposed to go up here.
Much quieter. It was so safe where that was, though. Hmm. You'll have to bridge the gap somehow since the scaffolding collapsed.
Okay. Can do. That! It did expect me to at least use the couches to like block the lasers, but I guess I was trying to think a little bit too hard for like these first levels, which is not recommended for any puzzle game, thinking too hard.
Okay, it looks as if the motor has stopped. You'll need to get that arm rotating fast enough to reactivate the generator.
Gramps, why do you make these things so ridiculous?
Two to go. That reminds me of the time when the DC voltage was offset. So bad, was it? Why don't you take a look at those blueprints?
Okay. Okay, so these just basically tell me if I missed anything or if I want to repeat anything. But
splendid. It seems as if the power is starting to come back online. As I still haven't been able to figure out how to get out of here, you'll have to make it to the next generator. You can access the next wing of the manor and the power grid sector by heading up the stairs there.
But I think I'm gonna actually gonna quit streaming for now. I think this is a short game, but I also remember a lot of these puzzles being very difficult, so who knows? I'm gonna do a sector each time I stream this. So, this is where we will stop it for now. And we will continue with more Quantum Conundrum another time. Thursday, more Stardew Valley. And then Saturday, I'm bringing something a little bit different, just to take a break from Dishonored. Bring something new. So, good night, everyone, and thank you for watching.